are prevented from disclosing things that they know, and the argument that they would make is itself classified. Soon enough, unless the president objects, the world will see this memo, but Democrats will still be muzzled by the classification of it all. They won't be able to issue a direct rebuttal. It's the direct rebuttal that they've prepared. Where this stands procedurally, the memo here in the White House, the president and his senior advisors have 5 days to review it and voice any objections in writing signed by the president himself that would be then transmitted to the House Intelligence Committee. Any member of that committee, 4 days after that, would have the power to bring the matter to the floor of the House in a privileged resolution to trigger a closed-door two-hour debate, which would be kept from the American people while the House could deliberate in secret. After that, the House would come into a public vote, which we'd all be able to see, as to whether to accept or reject the Intelligence Committee's recommendation to release the memo against the president's wishes. This is a process you may have never heard of before, because it's never been used before.
It's interesting the twists and turns that have been affected here, but in some ways Trump has been vindicated as it relates to his objection to Andrew McCabe's involvement in the Clinton investigation as a result of the money that were donated to his wife's campaign for a state Senate race, almost $700,000 from Terry McAuliffe's controlled organization, the PAC, and the Democratic Party in Virginia, folks within the FBI themselves, Peter Strzok and Lisa Page, had a text message about saying that he should recuse himself.
Well, without passing judgment on that, some of the facts that you just laid out, I would say that certainly this is something that the president and Republicans in Washington have been trying to draw a great deal of attention to, and they see it as part of a pattern that perhaps over the course of the last 10 years or so, the FBI has been at the highest echelons run by people who, as we now understand, have an inclination against the president. I mean, you can see it in the text messages sent between Strzok and Page about how they clearly don't like the man. That said, we still don't fully understand, although we hope to learn more, about the extent of the influence, for example, that Strzok and Page had on either the Clinton email investigation or the Russia probe. The memo may shed a little bit more light on that, and we look forward to reading it just as much as anyone else does. But
Speaker Ryan believe that we ought to just put it all out there and let everyone decide. I mean, you get mystified by the fact that this buildup comes up and all of a sudden it becomes a partisan issue as opposed to just the transparency of it. And obviously there are a lot of folks replete with conflict that have been involved in this situation. And all of a sudden everybody is heaping down on this four-page memo saying, well, we don't want anybody to see it.
Well, Democrats say that the concerns of the Justice Department should be heeded. But separately, they said if you're going to put out at least one side of the story, then the other side of the story should also be aired. I think a lot of us in journalism would love to read it and love for everybody else to see it too. Obviously, it's an ethic of ours that sunlight is the best disinfectant. We don't believe that the government should be doing much in our name with our money to keeping it secret.
Right. Well, Peter, Steve, thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate it. Got to get to a break, and we always enjoy your insight into these matters.
You bet.
Thank you. Well, you'll be right back. Got to take a break. We want to hear from you. 260-1870. Do you believe that, Andrew McCabe was forced out by the president, or is this Christopher Wray, the new FBI director, just kind of reconstituting his executive team? We'll be right back after the break.
And New Orleans is the mighty Mississippi, WWL AM and FM. Take your bucket list goodbye. WWL wants to send you on the ride of a lifetime. Roll in the crew of Argus with everything you need, costume and pros, free. Want more? You've got it. We're giving away two rides with all the fixes. Want to win? Go to WWL.com now and click on the contest page to enter. Kick that bucket list to the curb. Ride in a Mardi Gras parade. The crew of Argus from Sprint. Let the good times roll. And your Mardi Gras information station, WWL.
Cryptocurrencies are the future of money.
Hi, I'm Hedge Fund Manager James Altucher. I know you've seen all the press on Bitcoin's historic rise. My investment group made almost $2 million in a matter of months from a single trade. But here's the thing. The fast money on Bitcoin has been made, but there are more cryptocurrencies poised to take off, like Verge. If you had invested a $100 bill earlier this year, you could have cashed out with over $57,000 in a few months. We are at the beginning of a cryptocurrency explosion, but you have to move fast. It's critical that you invest by February 2nd, where one of the world's largest online companies could potentially make a huge cryptocurrency announcement. Here's what you need to do. Go to CryptoNow.com and order my video series and book. I'll walk you through how to turn a small investment into a retirement fortune. Remember the web address, CryptoNow.com. For once in your life, get in on the ground floor.
The following is a celebrity impersonator.
Hello, this is James Mason. Now, I've never played James Bond, but I've always wanted to. And if you want to look the part, you need to go to Tuxedos to Go today. Remember this number, 007. And then this one, 169. That's right, $169 for a tuxedo, shirt, tie, and cummerbund to own, not to rent. Why rent your look when you can own your look thanks to Tuxedos to Go? Tuxedos to Go is your answer for all of your formal prom, wedding, and mardi gras needs. So visit Tuxedos to Go today in Metro in Louisiana at 3416th Street in Metro, 504-455-5393. Or visit them online at tuxedostogo.com. That's Go with a G-E-A-U-X. Is that how it's spelling it down here? Right. Tuxedos to Go, where their tuxedo is their bond.
The ultimate driving machine is at Peak BMW. And right now, during the construction of their new facility, you can lease a new 2017 320i sedan for just $199 per month. Take a peek into the future at peakbmw.com or visit Peak BMW on Veterans in Kenner. 36-month lease, $199 per month payment, zero security deposit and acquisition fee. $4,252 signing, residual $22,911 credit permitting 10K miles per year. Fees may apply for excessive wear and tear. Plus tax title license through January 31st, 2018.
Hello, Mike Warden, Mike Warden's Liberty Safe. And a new year comes with some great new safes from Liberty Safe, like the brand new National Classic 60 with an 8-in-1 interior. Also, the new USA Series safe starting at just $9.99. And the on-the-go magnetic pistol cases in three different sizes starting at $59.99. We invite you to stop by either one of our great showrooms in Baton Rouge or Mandeville and check out all that the new year has to offer. And remember, as always, lock them up.
So good, you can't stop thinking about it. Imagine a grilled chicken breast sitting on top of fettuccine noodles topped in a creamy spinach Alfredo sauce, topped with fresh tomatoes and bacon. That's our Big Cheese Chicken Florentine at Bobby Hebert's Cajun Cannon Restaurant. And for dessert, dig into our banana softer ice cream cake, topped with caramel, strawberries, chocolate, and pecan. Only at Bobby Hebert's Cajun Cannon Restaurant.
Mardi Gras 2018 is going to be a giant party.
Celebrating your engagement.
Correct.
Back to Newell Norman. Bringing truth to power on WWL, AM, FM, and .com. Call 504-260-1870 or text 870-870.
We're back, and we've been talking about the Andrew McCabe stepping down as the deputy director of the FBI, whether or not that was initiated by Trump criticisms, or, you know, Director Christopher Wray wanting to put together his own new executive staff, which I don't think is out of the ordinary. We're going to want to talk to Mel on the North Shore. What's going on, Mel?
Hey, cool.
Yes.
When you step down from being the sheriff of Jefferson Parish, you have another gig already lined up, didn't you?
When I step down?
Yes. Okay. So Chris Roy has the right to pick his own attorney that should have done that just like Trump did when he got in office and which is missed all the gifts that the United States attorney. He just done that from now to then. So why hadn't he had a replacement for Keith when he pressed him to quit?
Well, you know, my belief is simply this. I think because of all that was going on, the tug of war in Washington, there was no good time for this situation. I would remind you that Andrew McCabe had already